This week, I am going to share something with you that I got in the mail, something that is exciting for authors. If you haven't guessed it yet, that is my author's proof copy of my book. So I'm going to talk a little bit about why I did it the way that I did and what I'm doing with the author proof copy so you could maybe do this for yourself. So excited to have looked it over. My initial reaction was one of excitement, of course. My husband actually opened it up and gave it to me before I had the chance to tell him to let me open it. So I'm just showing you instead of like unboxing it or revealing it or whatever. I decided to go ahead and order the paperback version so I could do some proofreading before I release the ebook, because I feel like there's a different kind of way that you approach reading and a different way that you look at everything. And I feel like for me, it's easier for me to catch mistakes when I am reading it in this format. So your eyes just kind of read things differently in different formats. And I decided that I wanted to take the time to read it in this format, look for any proofreading mistakes, and even anything else that I catch as I'm reading. And then I will release it in ebook format, and then I will release it in paperback later. I just thought it would look cute in this larger size. So here you have it. This is the paperback version. And you can see this is the cover. If you don't follow me on Instagram, this is what the cover looks like. I just did a reveal recently. And the title of this episode is The Glimmer Princess. So each episode is going to have a different title. And I'm not sure what I'm going to call it as it's combined as one novel. I haven't decided that yet. But this is episode one, The Glimmer Princess. And up here it says episode one of the Mermaid Kingdom series. The character artwork was done by a friend and a former client of mine. I created her website for her, I don't even know, like 4 years ago or 3 years ago. And so we've been friends ever since, and she's a wonderful artist. I have her art in my home. I'll share it here for you to be able to see. And I decided to hire her because I knew she would create exactly what I wanted. So she did the character art. So just Ava here, my main character on the cover. And then I have another friend, Ingrid, who she created this background. She created the ivy on here. And then she created the back cover, which I have to still put the book blurb, you know, like what the book is about on the back. So I haven't done that yet. And then here, this is just like the barcode from Barnes & Noble Press where I got the book printed. So I decided to go ahead and do this because I wanted to, of course, proofread it and look it through. And also as a graphic designer, because I have my degree in that and I worked as a graphic and web designer for 10 years, I really wanted to see it like in the physical version. So this didn't cost that much. This is, I want to say it's like 45,000 words, maybe a little bit less than that for this episode. So with that word count, the page number comes out to be 166 pages without any of the back matter that I haven't added yet. So pages like the author bio and anything like coming out next. So like episode two, I will eventually have pages in here that say, you know, episode two is going to come out, because it's also going to be in the ebook version. So might as well put it in here too. And then, you know, I'm going to have like acknowledgements of people who helped me to get to this point and things like that, that I just haven't made those pages for yet. But I wanted to see what it looked like with the cover. I wanted to see kind of like gauge how I wanted this to look. So what I did is, this is one file for the front cover, and the back cover is a separate file that I have to put the text on still. But then this, you just put into Barnes Noble Press the title and you put your name, and they have like four fonts for you to choose from. And you just choose the font and you plug in your information, and then they just make it look this way. And I decided to do it this way because this is such a small spine that I thought I'm not going to take the time to actually like make the spine in terms of the full file that you would make for a cover design. So I just instead I'm doing separate files. So a front cover graphic, and then a back cover, which will be a separate file. So I did that. And then the other things that I've done to get this ready, I did do a page here in the front that is the title page. And I have a logo that I need to put in here that's finished for my publishing company, whatever you want to call it. That I'm creating. I haven't done all of the steps that I need to do to create it, but I'm starting to get the things rolling to get that done. So I wanted to put that in here as well. And then, you know, of course I have like the copyright page, and I have the dedication page. And then, you know, let me go to like a random chapter. And then I have, you know, like you can see me proofreading my proofreading marks. And then I have the chapter headers, which this part here, the IV, that was done also by my friend Ingrid. And I'll put the information of the people who've helped me in the box below so you can go and check them out. So I decided to go ahead and get this printed so I could check all those things out, check out how the file looks to see if there's anything that I wanted to change before printing it. So like the separators, I don't know what you call them, scene separators, those I think I want to use a different font than what I am using because I don't really like the way that it looks. So it's little things like that that I want to change. I think one thing that happened is page 10 in here, for some reason, page 10 does not have a page number. So I want to fix that. So there's like some small things in terms of design that I wanted to see and I wanted to fix. So that's why I ordered it. And also I wanted to be able to proofread and to show, you know, you guys what it looks like so far and to talk about where I am in the journey of getting this printed. So that was the reasoning for me doing this. And I'm really excited. When I first got it, I thought to myself, like, it looks like a real book. It looks like a real book because it is a real book, but I expected there to be maybe more errors or more things that I would want to fix or whatever, but really there's not. Like, I really like the way the title looks at the top. Show you guys that there. I really like how my name looks. I pretty much really like everything about it. So I think the main thing right now, I need to make those back matter pages to put in the back. and I need to continue to go through and proofread it to find any other errors or anything that I want to change before I'm done. And so I have also an ebook file that I will do the same things to, which what I'll probably do is I will probably, I don't know what I'll do. I will, you know, correct the things that I need to correct. And then I will probably get another paperback just to like, make sure. And I may even try, because I did this through Barnes and Noble Press, I'm going to also print this through KDP to see what I think of the difference between this one that's been printed from Barnes and Noble Press and the one from KDP, and to see if there's anything with that version. So I think I'm just kind of looking and trying to see how things look. And I did print two of this. I think it costs like $3.84 or something like that to get this printed. I printed two because I knew I was going to mark this one up, and I wanted to have a second version to keep forever because it's the very first printing of my book. So I wanted to have that for myself to keep for forever. So anyways, that's about it. If you have any questions, I would love to hear your questions. If you want to know more about how I did this, or like for me to show you anything, let me know also in the comments below, because I would love to help you to get to this point if you're not there quite yet. I'm always open for questions on Instagram. You can follow me there. My name or my handle on Instagram is Amanda Lynn Creek. So I will put that here for you all to see. So you can go and follow me, and I'll have the link down in the description below. So that is it. I am excited to talk more about my book, about how I'm writing it, my plans for publishing, like actually getting it out to people and not just me. So I will be talking about that a little bit more in the next video. And I'm excited to share with you. So I will see you next time. And don't forget to like and subscribe and stick around for the rest of my author journey. Bye.